are your plans for re-entering the dating scene? When it comes to meeting the person you're intended to spend the rest of your life with, it may be a case of right place, right time. But that doesn't mean you can't stack the deck in your favor. Maria Romano welcomes you to True Love Knots. Today, we'll talk about your roadmap to finding love. Keep an eye out for Maria's ideas on how to improve your dating strategy for 2022.
Hey, everybody. Maria Romano here from True Love Knots. Okay. 2021 is almost gone. Oh, I hear my dog's groaning. Oh, yes. 2022 is upon us. And you know right now you're still single, right? You're still single. You want to find love. You might have been holding off, or maybe you're just doing the same thing over and over again. Stop right now. Now, you know, I'm a dating coach here in Las Vegas, Nevada, and I work with many people that are looking to find love again. And my topic of conversation today is going to be about what is your game plan for getting back into the dating world or revamping or rebooting what you're doing for 2022. So my friend, let me tell you, hold on right now. If you have yourself out there on the dating sites, kind of put it aside till after Christmas, after New Year's. People are going away. So don't get discouraged, but 2022, boom, is going to be here. And I guarantee you, there's going to be a plethora of people on the dating sites out there networking. And you want to be a part of it, don't you? But you need a game plan. So let's talk about what is your roadmap to finding love. So the first thing you need to do is write down and assess what you want from a relationship, okay? What are your must-haves? That is the first thing. Now, maybe your must-haves, you want somebody that has a healthy lifestyle, right? Maybe you want somebody that is a little adventurous because you might like to hike. You might like to mountain bike. You might like to go river rafting. So whatever it is, write down what your must-haves are. Five of them, just five of them. Okay, that's the first thing. The second thing is write down what your deal breakers are. That's right, write down. And the reason you write this down, this is your game plan for your dating life to finding love, is because when you do so, it takes on a life. Those words will jump at you and you're going to read them out loud. Okay, and you're going to be accountable to yourself when you get out there in the dating world, if you haven't been or just getting back in the dating world, because you want to make the right choices. Heck, we don't want to date forever, do we? Right? You want to find somebody. So you're going to write down five things that you want that are a must-have and five things, or maybe two or three things that are a deal breaker. And don't put down that the person needs to be taller than you or shorter than you. I mean, let's get realistic. There might be that perfect person for you that could be a little shorter, could be a little taller. So don't discount. Write down things that are very important. So for example, if you don't want somebody that smokes, right? If you don't want somebody that isn't into family, those are things that are important to you. You know, maybe you want to write down that you don't want somebody that's a couch potato because you're the type of person you like to get up and go. You want a travel partner. You need to write that down. And the reason you need to do so, and you need to be honest, is then you need to formulate all that. And you might then move to going online. You might decide, okay, one of the things you want to do is you want to make sure that you're getting as much engagement as possible and much exposure as possible. And you need to put yourself on some dating sites. So find some dating sites that you think would complement who you are. I was speaking to one of the gals that has been part of my coaching group for a long time, and she's been very resistant to online dating. She's very religious. And I said, you know what? Put yourself on a religious site. She says, I never thought about that. There's Christian Mingles, Christian Singles. So whatever it is, find a site that's going to work for you. But you want to find a site, a dating site that has features like video chat features, things like that. Because, you know, you want to be able to meet somebody through video chat. It saves you a lot of time and headache. But let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. So you take the five things you want, the five things you don't want, and you start writing a profile a little bit about yourself, because you're going to put yourself out there. And it's two or three paragraphs about, hey, you know, my name is, and I just love to get up and go. There are times I'm the spur of the moment gal or guy where I might say, let's go take a road trip to blah, blah, blah. So, you know, I'm looking for somebody that wants to explore the world with me, that wants to have fun, but that's also family oriented. And also I'm very devoted maybe to my religion or whatever it is. You write that down. You want to be authentic. You want to write down that you're looking for somebody. Maybe you're looking for just a travel partner. Maybe you're just looking for a companion. You're looking for somebody that you want a long-term relationship, an LTR. It doesn't necessarily have to mean marriage, but somebody that you want to be committed to. Put that down in your dating profile. It is a must-have. Okay, do not put down about that you don't want drama in your life. You don't want somebody that's an alcoholic or a gambler, because you know what? That's exactly what you're going to attract. Put down what you want. Put down what you like. Put down your expectation of what you want in a relationship. And somebody that's reading your profile should read your profile. And you can always go back and ask him or her, hey, did you read my profile? Okay, because your profile is a short bio about you. Make sure your pictures look good. Make sure they're current. And don't put a picture where you cut somebody else out. Okay, please don't do that. Do 4 to 6 shots, full body shots, headshots, things of you being active. But that's what you need to do. So that's part of your dating plan for 2022, is revamp your dating profile. Or if you haven't done one before, go to my website, maria@truelovenots.com, or DM me, and I will send you a free profile starter kit so that you can put out the best version of you. But we just don't stop there, right? We just don't say, okay, I have the dating sites and that's it. No, no, no. Get out there. Go out with your friends. Go get out with some activities, find some meetup groups, make it a point of finding a few meetup groups and getting out there and connecting. Maybe it's once a week, maybe it's twice a week, maybe it's twice a month, but make it a point. Put it in your calendar, okay, that you're going to get out there and you're going to network. If you're in the business world, go to networking groups, okay? And then also, don't forget to enlist your friends and family. I'm looking for love. I'm looking for love. Tell them I'm looking for somebody and tell them what you're looking for. Keep your feelers, right? Send out your feelers. It's just like looking for a job, because you know what? There's a lot of people out there that want to find love. There's a lot of people, but they just don't know how. But you're going to be ahead of the game, my friend, because you're going to have this dating plan. You have this roadmap. You wrote down what you want in a relationship. You wrote down what you don't want. You put together a great bio. You got to get some great pictures. If you don't have a good down, you know, a profile kit, download mine, find some websites. Okay. Also put yourself out on meetups, get out there, check the Eventbrite groups, go out there. We're getting back into society. There's no reason for you to stay behind your computer, because this is what I just said to a group I spoke to the other night. Prince or Princess Charming is not going to knock on your door. You have to get out there. You need to take the first step. Don't think anybody else out there is going to be a matchmaker for you. You need to be your own matchmaker. You need to take action. And when you're prepared, I know you're going to find that perfect person for you. So this is great information that I shared with you. And again, if you need a profile starter kit, download it. If you think you need an accountability buddy or somebody to help you with your dating life, message me. I've got some great coaching programs available. I'd love to chat with you. I always give everybody a free half hour complimentary call. So if you want to just tap into my brain, I'm here for you. You know why? I have a passion and I have a purpose. Okay. I want to see you find somebody that's right for you. You know, over the last year and a half, we've been on pause. We've been in intermission, and there are so many people out there that are lonely, that are depressed, and they need to find love, because you know what? Life is better when you have somebody in it, somebody to share, somebody that you can kiss goodnight, somebody that you can hold their hand, somebody you can have a glass of wine. Sorry, my phone is going. So take advantage, map out your strategy, just like you write down your goals for 2022. What are your goals? What are your goals in your dating life? What are you going to do differently? Okay, the same thing you might do in your professional life, you need to do this in your personal life, especially if you don't want to be by yourself, because there is somebody there for you. But that somebody is not going to just come knocking at your door. You need a game plan. So think about this game plan, this roadmap that I have mapped out for you. If you have any questions, please let me know. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If there's something that you want to contribute, hey, DM me. I love to hear from people that listen to me. Because you know what? The world needs more people out there that are looking to find love, but in a healthy way. And I want to help you find love and enjoy your life. Because you know what? You deserve to find the perfect person for you. You deserve to have somebody in your life that you can come home to at night. You deserve somebody that's going to be there for you. So my dear friends, 2022 is around the corner. Remember, stay healthy, happy, and safe, and spread love. Happy New Year.